Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. So in the last part we cleared this secret tower. And let's get some of these guys out of the way as well. May as well just clear everything out of here. Pretty sure these guys don't drop anything dangerous. No poison in level 2 except from the giant scorpions, which we'll save for later, like I said earlier. Actually, there's still a few fire elementals we saved in level 1. Might be good to clear those out, but I guess we'll do that later. Reason why those are worth saving is because they drop pendants, and pendants are extremely useful later. Pendant will instantly open any door on screen, so if you have a room in a tower with 3 locked doors, you can just use one pendant and it'll open all of them instantly. I think we cleared them out. Yep, the assassin's bugs are gone now. So with that out of the way, we have now definitively finished off level 2. So it's about time, I think, for us to move on to level 3. Just trying to think if there's anything else I need to do here, but I don't think so. There's still a few loose monsters running around level 2, but they're not really worth hunting down, especially if you have to waste keys to get at them. If it was like a kraken or something that drops a lot of gold, it might be worth it, but right at the moment, I don't think so. Same for these shops. There's no real reason why you'd want to waste keys on opening little shopping areas when you can just go back to level 1 or whatever. We do need some more food. We're down to 3,000, so that's going to run out not too long from now. I'm going to invest heavily so we don't have to come back for a significant amount of time. I think if we drop 1,500, that should keep us tided over for a decent amount of time. Yeah, so we cleared all the towers from level 2. No real reason to go back in there. Oops. It's always a little bit tricky. There we go. Okay, back in level 3. Yeah, I think we'll probably just run around and get rid of the beholders we left last time. You know what? I'm just gonna magic them away. Because beholders are annoying. The sooner you can get rid of them, the better. Especially because they don't drop anything worthwhile anyway. Let me think. Okay, so we can either go down below, but again, we'll need keys to get into the good areas down there. Which eventually we will definitely want to do, but for the moment, I think we'll try and do the top part of the level first. And yeah, let's go over here first, clear out the rest of the guys we left back here. So some giant slugs, if I remember. Yep. We'll clear out the outside creatures first, and then we'll have a look at the dungeons, or the towers, or whatever you want to call them. Oh yeah, we opened the other side. Oh, there's another slug. Oh, that's right. There's 2 more. Get rid of these guys. Pretty much nothing in level 3 is going to give us any more trouble, except maybe some leftover beholders in the towers. And that's mostly because their spell is pretty powerful compared to our magic resistance. I think that's going to be our next target, is to upgrade our magic resistance a bit more. I guess we can finish off this last guy. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna leave this last guy probably. Because again, it'll be useful to have available poison later if we do pick up some karma somewhere. I'll actually showcase karma in a little bit, I think. You know what? Actually, I might do it in this video. Then again, no, those renals are... Oh, well, we'll see. So, these lampreys shouldn't be much of a problem now that we have our armor. And our massive, massive axe. Gotta be a little bit careful, because one of the incarnations of lampreys drop poison, and I'm not sure which one it is. It could be the first one. Maybe all of them. Be very careful, yeah, exactly. So yeah, we don't want to pick that up right now. Get rid of these guys. Pick up lots more fighter experience, because we need it. I always like leveling up my fighter side more than my wizard side, because I use fighter attacks more than I do magic attacks. But we talked about that as well. Go, brown potion. Can't hurt. Not like a poison potion. Now we'll be careful again, because this might actually be a poison potion. Yep, it is. So number one and number three are poisonous. And then there's the final one. See. You might be hearing a lot of static in the background. That's actually not static, it's raining pretty heavily here. So yeah. If you're hearing a lot of background noise, that's it. Yeah, and more poison, okay. So lampreys are bad news. Chase down this Grimlock. Wow, lots of them. As you can see, the if monsters have a magic attack, it almost always follows their movement pattern. So if they're moving to the left, their magic attack also moves to the left, and so on. Except when they've just fired it, in which case it'll usually go into a straight line. So yeah. You know what, I think maybe I'll cut off the video here and make one more short video which shows the effects of karma and maybe show the effects of a few of the items. That might actually be good. So I'll cut off the video here. I'll keep playing from this point on in the continuing videos, but I'll make one little in-between video just to show you a few of the effects that you really don't want to happen. So yeah, I'll see you in the next part, guys. Thanks for watching.